The billionaire Koch brothers, the geniuses who helped bankroll the Tea Party movement, are trying to buy up media outlets across the country. If they're successful, they'll be able to spread their anti-consumer lies to millions of Americans. I have Howard Nations and Mike Berg with me now to talk about the conservative takeover of the media. Well, guys, it looks like the Koch brothers, they want to control politics by way of PAC money. They want to control the courts by way of packing the court system with their favorite kinds of judge. Now they want to really embrace as much as they can the media. They don't think it's enough that Rupert Murdoch is out there with Fox News. They don't think it's enough that you have, as we sit here and speak, for every 6 minutes there is of progressive talk or progressive media in America, there is 3 hours of conservative media. So now the Koch brothers come on the scene and they say, hey, that's not enough for us. We want to buy up all the newspapers. Howard, let me begin with you. What is your take on this?
Well, in 2010 at a convention, the Koch brothers announced a three-pronged 10-year strategy. And their goals in it are smaller government, less regulation, and less taxation. The part that they're looking at here, which is very big, is less taxation. This is they're grassroots activists. Their three goals are grassroots activism, influencing politics, but then their third goal was to control the media. And this is such a dangerous thing. If you look at what they've done in the past in the things that they buy into and what they control, a quick example is what they did at Florida State University when Florida State sold their soul to the devil in exchange in 2008 for millions of dollars contributed to their economic department. The Koch brothers contributed money. Right. And when they got into Florida State, they were financing multiple seats for new faculty members. Well, when you do that normally, that's just donated money. What they did is they controlled the hirings, and they denied 60% of the faculty members that were to be hired by within the university. They reviewed all public materials, and they reviewed all publications, and they maintained the right to withdraw if they were not happy with the results that they were getting from the publications.
Ayn Rand had to be taught at FSU. You can't teach anything about global climate change. You have to teach the economics of deregulation. That's the Koch deal. Now, Michael, let me ask you this. What are the newspapers, what is the media that's targeted by the Koch brothers right now as we speak?
Well, they're looking to buy the Chicago Tribune, the LA Times, the Baltimore Sun. What's interesting about this is as we go back to history in the 30s, we know in Germany, if you control the media, you control the propaganda, you're able to sway public opinion and basically control the thoughts of people. But there's really a two-pronged thing they're going to accomplish here. They're going to do that, but the other thing is these are in places where Obama and the Democrats have done really well, in Illinois, in Chicago, in Baltimore, in Los Angeles. These are also unionized papers. What I see happening if they buy them, they're going to break the unions. They're going to fire as many people as possible. They're going to put their own people in there. They're going to actually destroy those papers and bring them all up and resurrect them in their conservative bent to try to put out propaganda to try to continue to rule this country with the corporate entities controlling government.
Well, Howard, let me ask you right now, if they accomplish what they want, It's not just that they're going to control these papers. What they're going to control is the narrative and the dialogue that spans as many newspapers as possible. In other words, you create the talking points on the editorial page of the LA Times, for example. That's right. Picked up by all of the other feeder newspapers and feeder media. Isn't that where they're headed, just to control? For example, regulations, deregulation. What would they do with that?
Well, their idea is to distort science on deregulation. They are very heavily financing now the fake scientific studies that regard climate change as a hoax. The reason they do that and the reason they're so big on deregulation is because they are the fifth largest air polluters in the United States. Their industries include fertilizer, fracking, coal, chemical plants, things of that nature. And we can see from just what happened a few days ago in Texas, what happens with deregulation. In the Texas fertilizer plant explosion, there were 15 people killed and 200 injured. 10 of the people killed were first responders. That fertilizer plant was classic deregulation, which is brought about by Governor Perry. He goes around the country bragging about how come to Texas where business is not regulated. Well, there had been no inspection of that plant since 1985. And they also are required to report to Homeland Security. They had never reported to Homeland Security that they were stockpiling that much fertilizer in one location. So this is the type of consequences that you get when you get no business regulation. Now, what you have to ask yourself is this. Would newspapers, which are currently coming out and criticizing Perry and criticizing deregulation, would those papers now be doing the same thing, and would they be investigating that explosion if they were owned by the Koch brothers?
If I were to say, what is the brand of the Koch brothers? Understand, the old man Koch was an evil little character. I mean, he is the guy that fought civil rights at every turn. He's the same guy that, you know, day in, day out was trying to build the John Birch Society. But when you take a look at the heart of what the Kochs have stood for, it is hate. I mean, there's no other way. It is a hate train, Michael. And what I'm wondering is, won't we see, haven't we seen this pattern with these hate groups? You know, it started off with the Tea Partiers, and everything coming out of their mouth was, you know, basically attacking the have-nots of this country, attacking Obama, it was constant attack and constant hate. You'd see them in line with their signs of Obama depicted as a monkey, Obama depicted as Hitler, and the message was always hate. The Koch brothers paid for that. What makes you think anything's going to be different when they own the newspapers, Michael?
Well, there won't be anything different. As you said, in the father, who was really the founder of what they've done here, said that the black man was nothing more than a communist plot to overtake America. The reality is that they're going to continue to preach hate. They're putting their money in, and they have so much money, into ALEC, which we've talked about previous on this show. They're putting their money in deregulation. They're putting their money in making sure that our environment is not clean. And in fact, they are one of the largest polluters in the world. The hate that they're going to continue to spew out of these newspapers and through the organizations that they've cloaked in legitimacy will continue to happen in this country. And America should be warned that this is what their agenda really is.
Well, Howard, we have seen this. We have seen when they've taken over. You pointed about Florida State University. It's barely, I don't even know how you call it a university where you have any free thinking now, because now it is the University of the Koch brothers, because the Koch brothers at Florida State University are telling them what to say, how to say it, who to hire, who to fire, what they can teach in their textbooks. And so what we see happening here is we've seen them time and time again when they take over a company, they fire the people who disagree with them. Now, can you imagine going to the LA Times in firing the editorial page because the people, the writers on that editorial page are not going to agree with anything that the Koch brothers have to say. They've investigated the Koch brothers time and time again for all types of scams that the Koch brothers have carried out throughout this country. So what's going to be different here? I mean, they're going to go in, they're going to fire, they're going to rehire people that are nothing more than parrots. Is that journalism?
Well, as indicated by Clarence Page, with the Chicago Tribune, one of the finest African-American editorial writers in America. He's indicated that he simply couldn't work for the Koch brothers, just as it was very interesting that when this story circulated among editorial boards all over the country, how many people were afraid to comment? These are journalists, but they were afraid to use their name in commenting on what they thought about the Koch brothers taking over the newspapers. And another indication was the fact that when asked, they said they thought they would rather have Rupert Murdoch buy the paper than the Koch brothers. Now, what does that tell you? Look what Rupert Murdoch just went through in England. They would rather, the editorial boards would rather work for Rupert Murdoch.
Criminal conduct in the UK, where he's tapping people's phone. He's involved in absolute criminal conduct, Rupert Murdoch. And these newspaper people say look, give me Rupert Murdoch above the Koch brothers, because I guess it's a different brand of crime. Michael, it's not just the newspapers. We also see one America news network that's coming up. It's being paid for by one of the wealthiest right-wing neocon nut billionaires in the country that says that we need more than Fox News out there spewing hate. So they're going to start the One America News Network. Now, here's the point. Liberals, and I got about a minute, tell me what is your gut feeling? Why don't liberals do the same thing? Why are we so unwilling to start our own networks and jump behind the media? Why don't we see that?
Well, one of the problems is we don't have the financial wherewithal. We're individuals, like we've been talking about, who can go in and buy newspapers, start a brand new television station. Most of what goes on the liberal side is grassroots. And to be able to do that, we have to have, number one, the fire to do it. We got to raise the money to do it. We got to get people interested so we can have some balance in this country. What they want to do is they want to make Fox News the moderate. They want to make them the middle. And we all know that's crazy. Absolutely not. They're going to go.
Howard, have you seen unwillingness in about 20 seconds, and unwillingness by the liberal political movement to jump behind media?
Yes, there's a definite unwillingness and reluctance to do so. And unfortunately, the nature of the beast is that people like the Koch brothers, who have so much money, have it because they don't want regulation. They want to be able to move unrestrained. And that's the type of people that are putting their money into the right wing, because the right wing, when they say small government, they mean government we can control and that will not regulate us and not tax us. And that's where the money goes.
All right, guys, thank you. Very important story. It's one we have to keep up with, because it's going to continue to grow as a problem with our democracy.